Good morning, everyone, and welcome to this week's Kids Church. In Kids Church, we've been thinking about the armour of God. Paul told the Ephesians in his letter to them that we're all in a battle, but it isn't a physical war, but a spiritual one. Everyone is on one side or the other in this battle. Now, one thing worth knowing is that we already know who is going to win. The battle is between God and the devil. We all know that God wins the battle in the end. But in the meantime, the devil will do his best to hurt those who are on God's side. To protect us from the tricks of the devil, God has given us some virtual armour to protect ourselves. If we put on our armour, then we would be protected from whatever the devil can throw at us. Our first piece of armour to put on was the belt of truth. This is the piece of armour that is the one that holds everything else together. It means knowing that whatever God says is true and that Satan is a liar. And he's proved this right from the Garden of Eden. The belt of truth also reminds us to tell the truth ourselves. Our second piece of armour last week was the breastplate of righteousness. This reminds us to choose to do the right thing, to do what God would want us to do. Then, when we do something wrong, it has consequences with God, which Jesus has made right. But it also has some consequences on the earth. And Satan wants us to have these bad things happen because we haven't done the right thing. So we can put on the breastplate to remind us to choose to do the right thing. Let's watch this to find out about our next piece of armor.
You would think that sharing good news would be really easy, but there's a spiritual battle taking place between God and the devil over the hearts of each person on earth. God is fighting for people to know who he is and how much he loves them. But the devil, his enemy, is evil and will do anything to keep people from hearing the good news about God's love. So God gave us a piece of his armor called the Good News Boots. They give us the courage to go and tell the good news, just like Jesus taught his disciples to do. 3 days after Jesus died, God brought him back to life. Jesus appeared to his disciples on a mountainside near Galilee, and when they saw him, they worshiped him and thanked God for his love. Jesus had an important message he wanted them to understand. Jesus said, "Go and make followers of all the people in the world. Teach them to obey everything I have told you to do, and you can be sure that I will be with you always." The disciples knew that sharing the good news of God's love might be hard, but they did what Jesus asked them to do. When we decide to follow Jesus, we should tell the people around us the good news about him. It can be easy to make excuses like, "People might make fun of me," "I don't know what to say," or "It's too hard." But with the good news boots, God gives us the right words to say and helps us to not be afraid. Jesus' promise to the disciples is true for us too. He will always be with us. When we wear the good news boots, telling other people about God's love has the power to change their lives forever. We can put on the good news boots.
The good news boots, which are also called the shoes of peace, are all about telling people the good news about Jesus. In Roman armour, the shoes weren't there for protection on the top of the foot. They were a bit more like sandals, but they made it easier for the soldiers to move quickly and safely so that their feet were protected from the bottom. Now, the Bible actually says about these shoes that we should put them on to be prepared. The Romans kept their armour on all the time so that they would be ready for a surprise attack. When Satan comes, he isn't going to wait for us to be ready to put on our armour. We need to be ready at all times for a surprise attack, but also ready at all times to tell people about Jesus. Let's sing now and worship together.
God and make disciples of every nation, baptizing.
church has a word that they use for sharing your faith. That word's evangelism. We hear about people who are evangelists. Now, they're just people who go out to tell other people about Jesus. But the Bible says that we should all tell other people about Jesus. God wants everyone to know that he loves them and that Jesus came so that they can be forgiven for all the things that we've all done wrong. By telling people, we're making God's army bigger and Satan's army smaller. Remember, anyone who isn't on God's side in the battle is on the side of the devil. Think about people you know who don't know Jesus. They might be at school or in your clubs or even in your family. God really wants them to know him and to be on his side, the winning side, in the battle. Let's sing again to worship God who loves us so much.
I love to tell the story. It will be my theme in glory to tell the old, old story of Jesus and his love.
thing about knowing how to share the good news is knowing what you believe and why you believe it, so that you're ready to share that with others. We know that God loves us. We know that because of Jesus, we can be forgiven. And we know that once we die, we'll spend forever and ever, eternity, with Jesus. It can be hard to share what we believe. We might be scared that people will laugh at us or make fun of us, that we just won't know how to tell them or what to say. Or we might just think that it's just too hard to do. And these things can all be true. But what we have to remember is that we are soldiers, and soldiers are brave going into battle. And if we have on our armour, we don't need to be afraid of anything Satan can throw at us. God can make us brave and give us strength and courage when we need it. Shall we pray? Dear God, thank you for the armour that you give us to protect ourselves. Help us to wear it always so that we are ready when the enemy attacks. Thank you especially for the shoes which remind us to go out and share your good news. Give us courage to make us brave about telling other people about you. Help us just to tell our stories about who you are and all that you have done for us. And help us not to worry about what people think about us. Thank you, God. Amen. Well, that's all for this week's Kids Church. Next week, we'll look at the shield of faith. But this week, remember, God gives us shoes in our armour to prepare us to go. To go out into the world and tell everyone that God loves them. To bring more people into God's army. To know what we believe and why we believe it. And to always be ready to go. Without our shoes, we're not ready. And we can be brave because we're a soldier in God's army. I'll see you next week. Bye.
I put on the full armor of God, stand strong against the evil one. I put on the full armor of God, the full armor of God. First things first, got the belt of truth. Put on my boots, gotta tell the good news. The armor of God and the shield of faith. Got my sword and my helmet, now it's time to pray. I put on the full armor of God, stand strong against the evil one. I put on the full armor of God, the full armor of God. First things first, you got the belt of truth. Put on my boots, I gotta tell the good news. The armor of God and the shield of faith. Got my sword and my helmet, now it's time to pray. Put on the full armor of God, stand strong against the evil one. Put on the full armor of God, the full armor of God. I put on the full armor of God, stand strong against the evil one. I put on the full armor of God, the full armor of God. Now in faith we can stand, stand, stand against every evil plan, plan, plan. Now it's time to be strong, strong, strong. He has won. I put on the full armor of God, stand strong against the evil one. I put on the full armor of God, the full armor of God. I put on the full armor of God, stand strong against the evil one. I put on the full armor of God, the full armor of God.
Our struggle is not against flesh and blood. It's against the powers of this dark world.
I'm a soldier.
Therefore, put on the full armor of God. So you can stand your ground.
I'm a soldier in the army of the Lord. I'm a soldier.
all clothes on.
Until I die
in the army.